I want to show you today a trick that you can use if you ever find yourself in a situation dealing with clipped audio. I'm going to show you two different ways to do this. One using Adobe Audition, which is the thing that's a little bit better, and one using Audacity. Audacity is cool because it's absolutely free. But if you're ever in a situation where you have some clipped audio, this is all you need to do. First thing we do is pop into live demo mode. And I'm going to show you that in yesterday's video, in Final Cut here, you'll see all of that red straight across the top, right? This is severely clipped. Let's take a listen real quick. Here we are. We are live. Let me bring up comments real quick. Right? So that's just a little bit much. What you would do is just go into the file menu, and then you want to go to share. You want to export the file, and then just name this file. All right. I already have one on the desktop, so I'm just picking that. One of the things in the settings, make sure you have audio only. That's important. And then make sure it's on wave. So we're just going to go ahead and save that. And we're going to save it to the desktop where it's easy to find. The next thing we're going to do is, there's the file right there. I'm going to move this out the way. The next thing we're going to do is open up Adobe Audition. And let's get that. Give it a second to do its thing. And I'm going to bring Audition over to this main window here so that we can see what we're doing. Double click it to make it fit. And then all I need to do is drag in this clipped audio file. And there you see, again, it is heavily, heavily clipped. Give it a listen real quick. Here we are. We are live. Here we are. We are live. Working with the same file. Okay, so here in Audition, make sure you go up to the window menu. And you want to come down where it says diagnostics and make sure that is checked. If it is unchecked, just come down and check it. What that does is it opens up in the panel over here, markers, properties, and there is your diagnostic area right there. So under effect, you want to click on declipper, right? There's declicker, declipper, delete, silence, mark audio. Make sure you have the second one clicked. And then we want to set it for restore heavily clipped audio. If it's only lightly clipped, you can do that. You could also try restore normal. I'm going to choose this one because it just seems heavily clipped. All you need to do is press scan. It thinks for a second, and it's going to tell us that we have, I accidentally changed something. One second, let me do it again real quick. It's going to say we have 6,423 problems detected. Don't touch anything. Just press repair all. Give it a second to do its thing. It says it's going to take like 22 seconds. It is normally much faster than it says. And this is a M2 MacBook Pro. Slower machine is going to take a little longer, of course. Anyway, so now that's done, and you can see that file is there.
Let me bring up comments real quick.
Sounds so much better. Okay, so the next thing that I would do personally is come over here, go to amplitude and compression, and do hard limiter. And I would set the hard limiter to -3. There is a preset in the preset menu to set it to -3. And then all you need to do is press apply. It again takes a second, and you can tell it's perfectly limited here.
Here we are. We are live.
And that's how you do that in Audition. Of course, all you would do is go ahead and export your file. And then we would call this. And then I'll just do AA so we know which is which. Save it to the desktop. And then press OK. So that is that. Now, that is the Adobe Audition way. Again, the only situation that, say, Adobe Audition, it's a subscription thing. You have to have Creative Cloud. So I'm going to show you a free one for the people who stuck around this long so you can see. Here's how you can do it for free. All right, let's get back at it. We're going to come over here, and we're going to open up Audacity. We're going to take that same file and we're going to drag it into Audacity. Let go. There we go. So same exact situation here.
Here we are. We are live. Let me bring up comments real quick.
Ooh, that's nasty. So let's go ahead and pull that to full. The select all is what I did. I press Command A to select all. Then we want to go into the effect situation, go down to, let's say, noise removal and repair, and we want to do clip fix. Sorry, hiccups. Don't press anything, just press apply. Now, this takes a little bit longer just because, well, it's not as well written as Adobe, I guess, but it does work. Adobe just has a little bit more access to the hardware, the GPU and the CPU, so things move a little quicker. But hey, it's free. So that's all you need to know. So it's going to take another 8 seconds here. And let's just say 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bingo. There it is. Let's give it a listen.
Here we are. We are live. Let me bring up comments real quick. And I'm.
That's cool. That's cool. That little triple step there is probably because I'm recording in Audition, just again, isn't as easily programmed. Same thing here. Go under the effects, go to volume and compression, and then you can hit the limiter here. And in this case, I'm going to set it for -3. And then just press go, and it's going to give us the same kind of situation.
Here we are. We are live. Let me bring up comments real quick.
And again, all you would need to do is hit the export audio and then say save it on your computer. And then let's call it fixed. And then Audacity. Boom. Go ahead and export that. So in order to use these in Final Cut, you would just come back over to Final Cut, and then you would find the one that you wanted to use. So let's go and grab this from the desktop. It's more easy to find. Let's use the Audacity one. We're just going to drag it down here into Final Cut, and then we're going to take the top one and turn it off. There we go.
Here we are. We are live. Let me bring up comments real quick.
There you have it. If you are ever in a pinch, you can just take Audacity, which is free. You can just Google Audacity, or I think it's audacity.com. Download the macOS version. Make sure you get the version that works with your Mac, if you have an M series Mac, and then drop it in, go to the repair, press fix clip, run that normal settings. Don't have to touch anything, and then export it. I like to hard lemonade. You don't have to. Reality is, when you upload it to YouTube, YouTube's going to process it again anyway, but this will save your bacon. Now, you know what we say around here. I don't know who needed to see that, who hear that, but if it was you, write that down in the comment section below. If you are liking this video, go ahead and press the like button, press the subscribe button, ring the notification bell so that you can be notified whenever I'm coming to you live from a hotel in Vegas again. And right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video they think you should watch. And I agree with them because it's late. I've been in the air all day. I'm tired. I'm going to bed. Chee-hoo.
I need to know everything. Who in the what and the where. I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but act like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George. I hop in the Porsche. 5 and a horse. I'm ready for war. I'm coming for throws to turn.